Hi, it's Jordantine1, and in this tutorial, I'm going to show you how to make this flower handle to go with your flower basket. So I do have a previous tutorial in which I show you how to form the basket, and then this is part two where we're going to attach and form the handle. To make your handle, you're going to need a hook of some sort. So I have the Rainbow Loom metal hook, but you can use a crochet hook or whatever you have available. I'm going to be using a twist tie to help me get my magic ring started, so that's optional, but I do find it very helpful, especially if you're new to Loomigurumi. You're going to need a few clips or stitch markers, and for my bands, I used all Rainbow Loom brand. So let me just break it down by each color. I used 147 white, 10 neon green, and 10 dark green. So really you just need a total of 20 of some shade of green for your stem or leaves. I used 62 pink, 4 fuchsia, 4 orange, 4 yellow, 4 neon blue, 4 purple, and then I used 2 neon orange, 2 of the light yellow, and 2 light blue. And those came out of the carnival mix. They are dual bands. They have white on the inside. And then I used 2 electric purple, and those are a glow-in-the-dark band. I'm going to begin by making a chain of 32. And I wanted to connect to each side of the basket. So we want our spacing to be correct, so we're going to start on the 16th stitch. So starting from the back here, where our previous row had ended, we're going to count 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16. So from the inside, I'm going to push through that stitch. I'm going to take my first band, and I'm using my basket color. I'm going to pull through that stitch and get the other end back on. So then I have 31 more bands. I'm just going to make my chain. So you're just pulling through and getting the other end back on. So this is actually going to be the bottom part of the handle because I want the flowers to be facing right side up from the front of the basket. So that's why we have to grow it from the bottom here. So I'm just going to let you finish the chain on your own, and then I'll come back and show you how to connect it. And now I'm going to count 23 stitches from where I have attached my chain on the left side here. So that's 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19, 20, 21, 22, 23. So I'm skipping those 23 stitches. I'm going to go into this 24th. So I'm going to make sure that this chain is completely straight here. I'm going to pinch the end in my fingers and remove my hook. Now in this 24th stitch over from where we attached, I'm going to stick my hook through. I'm going to grab one end, pull that through, grab the other end, and I'm going to pull one through the other. So now we've completed the first row of our chain. In row two, you're going to need 30 bands, and this is what's going to make the outer border on one edge of your handle. So it's going to be just like doing the back post single crochet or the front post single crochet, only we're doing it within the chain. So let me just show you quickly again what the difference is. If you're doing the back post single crochet, it's going to look like this, with the more apparent three-dimensional part on the outside. If you're doing the front post single crochet, it's going to turn out like this, where it's more flush with the handle. So as I said, it's very much like doing it within the basket, only we're just going in the chains. So we're starting in the first chain. You're going to push through from the top here, from the outside, and come up the next. I'm going to take my first band. I'm going to pull through everything. And now I am going to do one more thing. So if you want, you can add a clip if you're worried that you're going to lose your bands. If not, you can just hold them in your fingers. So I'm going to take my hook out. Again, I'm just going to hold this. And I'm going to go through the pink here. I want to make sure that it's right below. I'm going to push up through from the bottom, pull that under, and then get the other end back on. So the reason I'm doing that is to just totally connect this and try and give it a little bit more support where it connects. So you're going to do one through the other, and then you're going to go back down through that same chain, back out the next, and just like when we did it within the basket, you should see these two vertical loops pop right up on your hook. You're going to pull through, back on, one through the other two. Again, down through that same one, back out the next. Just try and be really careful that you're not hooking any of the bands along the side. You just want to make sure you're only getting those two vertical loops right on your hook. And as you grow this, you are going to find that it's going to really help support this. You can see that the chain is quite floppy. Definitely does not hold up. And this is going to definitely make it more rigid. So you're just doing one in each. So I'm just going to go ahead and let you finish doing that along the chain. And then I will come back and show you what to do when we get towards the end. Now I have one more band left here, and I have two more stitches, but it's my last one to go through here, my connection, my post. So I'm just doing the single crochet here. And now I want to make this nice and sturdy here at the connection. So what I'm going to do is take this off, leave it in my fingers. Again, if you don't feel comfortable doing that, you can add a clip if you're worried you're going to lose it. What I'm going to do is, from the inside here, I'm just going to push out through, I'm going to grab that, and I'm going to pull that through to the inside. So let me just add a clip on that, since it's in between rows here. In row 3, you're going to need 31 bands, and you should have a clip on your border color band, and it should be coming to the inside here of your basket. So you want to take your hook, and you want to get that on your hook, and then you also want to push through the next stitch over in a clockwise direction, or over to the right. So that's going to get those three loops on your hook. You're going to take your first band, and you're going to pull through all three. Then what you're going to do is you're going to go to your first stitch on the handle here, and you're going to push through that, get the other end back on, and it's going to pull through. You're going to have two loops, and one's going to go through the other. So I know that's a little bit unconventional. You can remove your clip, but I want to make the connections on either side of the handle to be as tight and firm as possible. So now you're just going to work your way across here, doing one single crochet into each. And then when we get to the end, we're going to do something similar to make that end nice and tight. So you are working from the inside of the handle. So what I'm considering front to back. Make sure you're going under both loops every time. And as I said, we are building our handle from the bottom up. So after this row, we're going to start doing the V pattern with our green. So I'm just going to go ahead and let you do this since it's just a regular single crochet. And once again, when we get towards the end, I will show you how to connect. Now I have two stitches left and two bands here. So again, front to back here. I'm going to go into the second to last. And then I'm going to go into the last stitch. But I also want to connect through this next band over on the basket. So I'm going to also go through that stitch. I'm going to pull through that stitch and then also pull through the next stitch. So I have the four loops caught in between here. Get the other end back on. You'll have your three loops and one through the other two. So now that's just another row that we've connected to the basket. And then I'm going to attach my clip. In row four, we're going to start our flower pattern. So it's the first row, which has the V stitches. So you're going to need a total of 32 white bands, or whatever your handle color is, and then 20 green. Now we're going to have to change the direction of our hook. We were used to going from front to back, but for this row we're going to have to go back to front. So the first thing that I'm going to do before anything else is I want to connect where our loose band is here. I want to get it to go under the next stitch on the basket. So from the outside I'm going to push through. I'm going to grab that loop. I'm going to take off my clip and I'm just going to pull this under. So that's just going to make that nice and tight against. And now, as I said, we're going from back to front. So in the next stitch here, I'm pushing through from the back under those two loops. So you're going to have three loops on your hook to start. Taking my first band, I'm just going to go underneath the stitch, get the other end back on. I'll have three loops. One through the other two. Then we're going to start our V-stitch pattern. So in the next row, again, back to front, you're going to take your first green, pull through, back on, you have three loops, and then your next one is going to pull through all three. You're doing a chain one, and then back through from the back side. Do your next green. Having a hard time seeing my bands on the desk here. And then you have your four loops. The next one pulls through all four. And then we're skipping two. So one, two. Again, always from the back. Let me just move these over here. I'm doing my next green, and I am going to alternate the green shades. So pull through all, then do that chain one, back through, my next green, and the next one through everything. So you're probably pretty familiar with this by now, so skip two. I'm going to switch back to my light green, or it's technically called neon green. So do that half double there. then my chain. And that next half double. Skip two. Chain one. And then last one here. So you're just going to continue and you're going to make 10 flowers. So we did the first four. So you're just going to continue on in that pattern. And then once again, I will show you what to do when you get to the end. Now I'm down to my last flower here. So I'm skipping two from the back, going through my green. Doing that chain, back through for my second, and then at this point you should have two stitches left. So the pattern is skip two, but I'm just going to skip the next one, and then again from the back, go through this last stitch here. Take my last band and I'm going to pull through everything. Get the other end back on, do one through the other, and then what I'm going to do is again hold this in my fingers. I'm going to go from the outside to the next stitch over here. I'm going to push down through the two loops. I'm going to pull this to the outside and then I'm going to attach my clip. In row five, we're going to complete the flowers. So you're going to need a total of 21 bands. So I was going to use 22, but I decided on 21, so just ignore that last one. And then 30 flower colors. So this is going to be slightly different than the way we did the flowers on the basket. So I'm going to do this entire row with you. Now we have our clip here on our band that's pulled to the outer edge of our basket. You're going to get that on your hook. Take off your clip. I'm going to go from the outside through the next stitch over on the basket. And then I'm also going to pick up the next stitch on the handle. So it's going to be the one that your first green went through for your V of your flower. So you're going to have two stitches plus an additional band on your hook. You're going to take your first band and you're going to pull through everything on your hook, get the other end back on, and do one through the other. Then that's going to take us to our next one over on the flower, and that is going to be the middle of the flower where we put the color. So same thing, you should have a space here from doing your chain one. This time we're working from front to back. I'm going to go underneath the chain and I'm going to pull through my first one and then again hold it in your fingers back through front to back. Pull through my second and then one more time, and you'll have to forgive me, the bands on the desk are going to get all messed up. So I did have the pattern laid out, but I know they're going to get out of position here. We have our band that pulls through everything, so remember, pull down as you're pulling through and you can slightly wiggle your hook. You're going through everything and one through the other. So with the old pattern, we would do two single crochets. With this pattern, we're doing just one. So in this next one over here, we're doing a single crochet. But then the next chain or stitch, we're skipping. So ignore that. You're going to go right into your next flower. So that's why I have a clip here that's letting you know to skip. So again, ignore this, go underneath that stitch or that chain one. We're doing one, two, three, and then we're pulling through everything, one through the other. Next one, we are doing a single crochet. And then the next one, we are skipping. So underneath, onto your third flower. So the reason that I'm skipping is because I don't want this to widen the way I did in the basket. I want it to be the same amount of stitches. And then the next one through everything. Next one, it's going to be the stitch where the other side of your V is the one you want to make sure you're going through, skipping the next one. So there's our skip. And now pull through the three bands. Again, you can see that sometimes I struggle with getting caught as well. So we have the next one. Wait a minute. Here's where I'm out of whack here. So I have the next one. And I'm not sure where I got this band from, but skip the next under your next flower. Again, don't hesitate to spread it apart if you feel like your hook's getting caught. Pull through everything. Doing the single crochet here. Skip. And then another single crochet. I think what I'm going to do is just slide all of this up. I apologize that it's going to be out of order. But we're skipping the next one. And the next color I have is actually the orange. So I think it'll be really interesting to see what color choices that everyone picks for their baskets and also their flowers. Kind of wanted to try a different color basket, but I was sort of afraid that it wouldn't look as nice with the flowers. But I think it'll be really interesting to see. Skipping into the next. Now I have my yellow. Now that they're out of order, I have to actually think about the colors of the rainbow. Skip the next. So I have two left here. So hopefully you should notice that your flowers are staying more close together. Skip. Here's my last one. So the first one is going to pull through everything. The next one is going to go in the next stitch. Now, I actually do have one band left here, but after examining it here, I've decided that I'm going to not use this band. So I'm going to take this very last band, I'm going to take it off when it's on my hook here. I'm going to leave it in my fingers, and what I'm going to do is go over to the next stitch, push through from front to back, and pull that through. I initially thought that I was going to use that other band, but I thought it was too loose of a connection onto the basket, so we're going to do that instead. So now you can see here how it's coming along. In row 6, you're going to need 30 white bands. So you should have your one loop with your clip on. It's pulled to the inside of the basket. You're going to get that on your hook. You can remove your clip. And then what I'm going to do is move over to the next stitch. And then I'm going to take my first band. I'm going to pull through the stitch and also through the loop. And then what I'm going to do is, while holding this in my fingers, I'm going to reach over, and from the inside here I'm going to push through the first stitch, and it's going to come through. You have your two loops, pull one through the other. So now we're going to go in every single stitch. Anything that looks like a stitch, we're counting as a stitch. We are going to have to go from back to front once again. So your next stitch over is going to be the one that's right on the very top of the flower. So it's just going to be regular single crochets. You're going to have two stitches in between your flowers. And you will probably notice that the first one's a little bit larger of a gap, just because we did skip. Then that next one is going to be right on top. You'll definitely feel that it's a little bit tighter to go through when you're above the flower. So then two in between. Just want to make sure you're not getting caught. You could see it sort of went through the middle of that yellow. You don't want that to happen. So don't worry also when there's that little bit larger of a gap, because once it all gets together, you're not going to see any large holes or anything. It's the same pattern that I used on my other handle for my other basket. Again, you can see there I sort of got through the pink. You want to try and avoid that, make it nice and clean. Sorry if this is kind of at an odd angle here. It's getting harder to fit underneath. So we're just about done here. We have just one more row to do. So hopefully everybody's really thrilled with the way their baskets are shaping up here. I really really love this flower handle. I think it just really sets everything off. But if you did want to, you could make a smaller handle, one that was not quite as wide and didn't have the flowers. And then you do sort of have one other stitch that you could go through, but we're not going to go through that. We're just going to go right into this next stitch over here on the basket. So I do want to pull that to the inside. So I'm just going to take my hook out. I'm going to reach through from the inside, push out through, grab that loop, and pull it through to the inside. So then I'm just going to take my clip and attach. In the seventh and final row, you're going to need 30 bands, and it's going to be whatever you want your border color to be. So I have my pink once again. So you should have your loose band on the inside with a clip. And what I'm going to do is I'm going to go through from the outside. I'm going to push through this last loop that we had just gone through on the basket. I'm going to push through that. I'm going to take my first border band. Now I'm not hooking the loose band just yet. I'm going to pull through. Then I'm going to go up to the next stitch right above from the outside in. And now is where I'm going to attach the loose band. Because if you attach it any sooner, it's going to just go right through to the other side. So unattach that. Make sure I get that on my hook. Then get the other side. Now I'm going to pull up through that loose band and the stitch and pull one through the other. So now you can see this is nice and solid as far as your border go. They line up with one another. And then it's just a matter of doing a regular back post single crochet. So down through the same, out through the next, you'll see your post on your hook, pull through, back on, one through the other two. Always down through the same, out through the next. I'm sure everybody is totally pros at this by now. So you're just going to do that the whole way across your handle, just to complete that other side of the border, give it some stability and make it look nice and decorative. Seems like I'm caught on something here. There we go. So you're just going to do that the whole way across. I'm going to go ahead and let you do that on your own so you can pause, and when you get near the end, I will show you how to finish it off. I have one more band to finish, and then I have a white band that I'm going to use to tie this off. So I'm going down through, and back up the next. So now I want to get this band to go towards the inside, so I'm just going to take it off. I'm going to reach from the inside, I'm going to push out through the basket stitch. I want it to be right next to the pink border, so they are right next to each other. Pull that through to the back so you can see that I don't want any gaps in there. So now I just have this one loose band to tie off. I'm going to just go through a couple of the white bands here on the inside, maybe like one or two. Take take my very last band, make a nice and tight slip knot, and then I'm going to hide the loop. So I'm just going to go through several of these loops on the inside. Just going to go in a straight line here, if I can get my hook under. Grab this and pull through. So you're going to have to go through several just to get it completely hidden here. And then you probably have to do a little bit of reshaping to your basket and to the handle. But it should be nice and firmly attached now. Should stand up pretty well for you. And your Loomigurumi flower basket is complete. I hope that everyone loves their new flower baskets complete with handle. You can always leave me comments on YouTube and Facebook. You can post pictures of your creations to my Facebook page. I absolutely can't wait to see everybody's basket creations. And please feel free to subscribe to my YouTube channel, so that way you can stay up to date on my latest tutorials. You can also find me on Pinterest and Instagram, so please post your pictures and comments there too. And if you do post pictures on Instagram, don't forget to tag me. And please feel free to subscribe to those as well. Thanks for watching!